In Excel, we can easily share, move, or duplicate data by using Excel's copy, cut, and paste tools. These tools are located in the clipboard group on the Home tab of the ribbon. There are four steps to the copy process. So, for example, if we want to copy the word total from E5 to A10, step one, click on the cell you want to copy. Now click Copy in the clipboard group. You will notice this dashed line appearing around the copied area. This indicates that the values have been copied to the clipboard. This is an area in memory that is shared by many applications. This allows us to copy not just to different spreadsheets, but even to different programs. Step 3, click in the cell where you want to paste the data. And step 4, click Paste. Note in Excel, it doesn't just copy the value in the cell, it also copies the formatting. Also, a little clipboard icon appears whenever you paste. This is very useful as it allows us to change our paste options at the time when we paste. If we click the drop-down, you will see some of the other paste options we could choose from. So, for example, if we didn't want the formatting, we could choose to just paste values. This clears any formatting, but be warned, it will also replace any calculations with the results from those calculations. Having pasted, our dashed line does not disappear. This means we can continue to paste the copied area. If you want to remove it, however, just press Escape on your keyboard. Now, often we're going to want to copy more than one cell, and Excel will happily allow you to copy much larger areas as well. So let's select this whole region, and this time we're going to use our right-click option. So right-click anywhere in the selected region and choose Copy. When we come to Paste, we do not need to select multiple cells. Just select the top left cell where you want the paste area to begin, and then we can right-click and just choose the first paste option to get the default options. The cut process is very similar to the copy, but it actually allows us to move data. So if I wanted this data to actually be on a different sheet, I could cut and paste. With it still selected, I'm going to click the Cut tool. I'm then going to come to Sheet 2, right-click on the top left cell, and paste. You will note, however, when you paste the data in a different sheet, although it brings through the formatting, it does not bring the column widths. So let's see how we could use our different paste options to address that. Coming back to Sheet 1, we're going to select our data again and right-click Copy. Then come to Sheet 2, and this time, just click in the top left cell. We're going to come to our paste options, and you will notice there's an option, sixth option down, to keep source column widths. And this time when we paste the data, we get the column widths coming through as well. Let's have a look at another really useful paste option. So coming to Sheet 3 this time, come to your paste options, and just next to the column widths, there's another one called Transpose. This is an interesting one. It allows us to swing our data through 90 degrees, so effectively what were columns become rows and vice versa. Finally, let's look at how we can copy into a different program altogether. So I'm going to come to a Word document now. Again, click where you want to paste and use our paste option to paste our data. And of course, you can copy from a different program into Excel as well. So if we select our heading, let's try our shortcut key this time. Control-C or Command-C on a Mac to copy. Back into Excel and onto Sheet 1, I'm going to click right in my top cell and then Control-V or Command-V on a Mac to paste. And that is how we can easily share, duplicate, or even move data using the cut, copy, and paste options in Excel.